And I'll define music that made the difference. And yes, we have to be more than a little crazy to challenge the oral status quo the way we did. So it's no surprise that Buddy Bolden, the preeminent horn player cut from this cloth, was an insane black man whose ascendancy to the throne just made it easier for the odorous forces of the status quo, as Caribbean scholar poet Kamau Brathwaite called it, status quo, to pluck Bolden from atop the heap and heave him into a mental institution and keep him there for almost 30 years, wasting away until he died. They may have silenced our first king, but they could never silence our sound. And regardless of what anyone says or does, nearly 100 years later, no matter whether they admit it or not, know it or not, like it or not, it is the bold sound of Black Buddy conjuring some raw, funky blues in the night, layering his tone on whatever was a given song's ultimate source. The Neo-African Gree-Gree is the sonic tattoo marking the beginning and making up the essence of the music we now call jazz.